Hi, good afternoon. My name is Nicholas, and I'm working on validation of informal learning with Enric. Marc Allier is not here, and Fran. So I will start with presenting some terminology and then move on to the state of the art so that I can put you all into context of what the idea behind my PhD is. Formal learning is the learning that we do in a formal education. It implies the existence of an actual education center, an institution or organism. It has a defined curriculum, a defined timetable, and leads to a recognized certification. Then we have the next two terms, non-formal learning, which is the learning that usually takes place alongside the formal one, but actually is not inside the curriculum. It is, however, provided in an organized and structured manner and works as a complement to formal learning. It doesn't have the constraints of formal learning as far as time and construct. And then we have informal learning, which is all learning that results from day-to-day activities and has absolutely no time or structure or obligation. For the sake of our work, when we refer to informal learning, we mean actually the two sets of non-formal and informal learning. So everything that doesn't take place within a formal institution. So some additional terms: lifelong learning is the learning that the individual does throughout their lives. And adult education refers to the education after the one that normally happens after formal education, school, university, or whatever is over. So with this out of the way, informal learning is officially recognized by the European Union with the Bologna Treaty in 1999. Since then, there have been a number of initiatives within the European Union that foment and promote informal learning. You have CEDEHOP, the European Qualification Framework, the Lifelong Learning Program, and the Inventory Project, just to name a few. CEDEHOP published a set of guidelines on validating non-formal and informal learning that happened 5 years ago, wherein they consider four different validation levels, which is the European, national, organizational, and personal. According to them, non-formal and informal learning can be validated using the same standards that we use to validate formal learning. Moving to the aspect of informal learning at the workplace, there has been mention in the literature of the benefits for the employees because a very active person in the field of learning has enhanced employability, shows that he's interested in continuously learning more stuff, which leads to improving their working conditions, and is in a lot of cases informal learning is actually more potent than formal education. For the employers within the workplace, it's very cost effective because they get a workforce that is more able than what their formal education would lead you to believe. It guarantees that their employees are kept up to date because they continuously learn and keep up with new evolutions. And also it shows that the workforce is able to evolve and adapt to different conditions that may arise. So, with all this interest and talk of informal learning, there have been a variety of tools. We have here a list. The Trailer Project is a project some of the people in this room participated in. It was led by the team here in Salamanca. The idea is to provide a portfolio for informal learning activities. And then you have a number of other initiatives, some providing support tools for people working with the unemployed, others that are more general purpose portfolios like Ten Competence and Mahara. And then you have some other initiatives like Mozilla, Open Badges, and the Degreed, which actually try to promote informal learning by giving the learners some recognition like virtual badges. So as far as competencies gained through informal learning are concerned, we need to translate the skills that an individual gains from informal learning to competencies. Because actually the competencies are what hold the actual value to the learner, and it's what the employers understand. There is a list provided by the International Labour Organization. If I'm not mistaken, the last edition was from 2008, that provides a very huge, enormous list of competencies. So, within this context, we have two hypotheses for our work. First is that informal learning is of real value to the learners, and this value can be evaluated quantitatively and qualitatively. And the second hypothesis is that informal learning can be represented in a structured way so as to be adequately represented in a curriculum or portfolio of formal learning. So, based on to these hypotheses, we define the objectives for our work, which is to evaluate the informal learning by defining a set of methods, metrics, and criteria, provide a more structured representation of an individual informal learning. This we hope to do using tags and ontologies to characterize this learning, and also promote the social aspect of informal learning by providing a social and collaborative framework. Here I would like to say that the research methodology we want to employ is that one of the active research, which means that we will be doing our investigation while actually dealing with the problem and providing an actual solution. And so the goals we have is are basically this list, seven goals, which is to do some research into the available informal digital informal learning resources, because we are talking about digital informal learning. We analyze the potential of these resources, design mechanisms for obtaining and these resources, define an ontology of tags for describing these activities, and when we have all these activities, design an informal learning knowledge base, and then once we have the informal learning knowledge base, we would like to identify the potential uses, its potential uses. It's a thing that we can not do it before we have a concrete image of how this informal learning knowledge base is going to evolve. And then define the set of competencies and skills that are that could be adequate and actually useful based on what we have. So, initial contributions. At this point, we are conducting a systematic review of the literature, so just to make sure that we're up to date with everything that is happening and has happened and all the available options we have. Meanwhile, this is a preliminary list of all the informal learning activities that we consider as interesting to us, like search engines, web pages, online authoring tools like Google Docs, for example, blogs, and what have you. And then, as part of the trailer project, we worked actively on developing one of its parts, which was the collector of the informal activities of the users. You can disregard this image, it's just the architecture of the entire trailer project is not very important. So, while running the pilots during the lifetime of the program, we had questionnaires filled by the users before and after the pilot phases. And these are some observations we made, we were able to make, that the institution users, like universities and teaching institutions, they were not overly aware of their informal learning. The company users were more aware of it. So, and the idea that such a tool where they could make use of their informal learning was well received, and they considered that the platform actually made them more aware of their informal learning. However, there were also some complaints that the platform, the interface maybe was not the best available, that was true. Also, maybe it was a bit disjointed the way we had it designed, and also the main complaint was that the list of competencies, the official list of competencies, was way too complex, way too large for it to be of any use. Our next steps is first to finish the systematic review, hopefully this month, hopefully. Then study the informal learning potential of the resources we have defined in the previous list, define a coherent set of competencies that are actually usable, define a set of tags for all the activities. We would like to have a predefined set of tags and maybe also allow user-defined tags, but that's for a future moment. Design the knowledge base, design then a validation framework for all the activities, and also the social framework to support and promote the informal learning. This is a work plan for 3 years. I'm not promising anything. And thank you, and if you have any questions.